So what I've done is just cracked a rad open to take the radiator off the wall. We're just doing a flush. But this one has been quite stubborn, so we're just going to make sure when we take this rad off, we can blast it outside and see if what sludge is in the system. You see, I've had a chemical in for 2 weeks of a cleaner, and we have used Ferroquest by Sentinel to also give it a deep clean. We ran that for about 3-4 hours. The water that we've got out of the system, as you can see, doesn't get much better than that. And I'll just give you a bite here. Can you guess what it is? And that's us putting our own magnet on and allowing it to settle. So yeah, it's in a very bad way. Okay, let's just see how we get on. As you can see, that's the water's coming out. Let's see what happens when I take the rad off and blast that through. Alright. Our plan now is to move this rad. We shut off the vent. We're going to flip this rad upside down. We're going to take it outside and then we're going to flush it. My colleague's going to record us, see what sort of stuff comes out. So we're outside now. This is the water that had come out of the radiator, believe it or not, after we flushed. So it probably is going to require a second flush. But as you can see, that is bad. I'll sweep that in a moment. Got the radiator set up here. So what I'm going to do is turn on the main. Thankfully, I've got a normal turn down on my hose. So we're going to start with something very simple by system. You've cleaned out the F&E tank. We'll supply pictures with that, with the thread. And this is run round. And this morning we came back, fitted a AD Magnet Clean Pro 2, and we added Ferroquest by Sentinel into the system. We've allowed that to run around between 3 and 4 hours at very high temperatures. Let that circulate. Now we're just taking each radiator off, making sure it's all flushed through, all the sediment and whatnot. As you can see, it's starting to run a bit clearer now, but please don't go by that. We're going to now put it over onto the other hole. And again, we're going to fire it out that way. And as you can see it, we're trying to get as much of the sediment out, which sits at the bottom of the radiator. My colleague's going to take over in a second, holding the phone, and he's going to record me flushing through. Okay,
we'll be right back. bit. Give it a good shake. Obviously, if this was a bigger radiator, I'd be asking my colleague, who's a lot stronger than me, to join in.